Joining me now is Noah Diffenbaugh. He's an associate professor of earth sciences at Stanford University and a senior fellow at Stanford Woods Institute for the Environment. Professor, great to have you on. Sorry about the circumstances. Give us a sense of historically how big these fires are, how much worse they've become in recent years.
Well, right now we have the second and third largest fires in California's recorded history, burning right now, and they're still expanding. It remains to be seen. Now, they've only been burning for about a week. So we've had more than 1 million acres burn since the lightning strikes started last weekend. That's what's happening right now. Over the long term, the area burned in the western United States has increased around tenfold in the last four decades, and we have very strong evidence that global warming has contributed about half of that increase.
Yeah, you. In fact, I was reading, you were a senior author of a Stanford University study I was reading earlier, and that referred to that human-caused global, human causes that have led to global warming have made these fires much more likely. What sort of role is climate playing in what's happening now in California, not just now, but in recent years? What have been the causes and effects?
Well, so fires always result from the confluence of multiple ingredients. There's the vegetation that is burning. There's the winds and the other climate variables, how much humidity is in the atmosphere, how hot it is. And then there's, of course, also the ignition, whatever is the cause of the fire. Where global warming is having the clearest effect is through temperature. That heat in the atmosphere is drying out vegetation. It's creating more flammable fuel on the landscape. It also means that when we have low precipitation periods, those droughts have been becoming more intense. So we're seeing an extension of the wildfire season in California. The Cal Fire now reports essentially a year-round fire season, and that's primarily the result of the long-term warming that's happened in recent decades.
So what's the answer? How to mitigate what's been happening in California and elsewhere, for that matter, that is climate-related? What can be done?
Well, you know, climate change is really about risks, and what we're seeing in California and more broadly in the Western U.S. and in other parts of the world is that the risk of extreme wildfire conditions is going up. Global warming is putting a thumb on the scales. The good news is that there are lots of opportunities to manage those risks. So how much global warming we get in the future, it depends on our greenhouse gas emissions. So there's opportunities to curb that trajectory. But there's also a lot of opportunities to manage the risks right now. Home hardening, forest management, hardening of the electrical grid. These are all measures that localities and states and countries can take right now to help build resilience. And then the other key factor that we're really reminded of this week in California is how thinly stretched our wildfire fighting system, both the people and the equipment, are during these large events. We saw it in Australia last year. We've seen it in California in recent years. It's happening right now. So investments in the people and equipment that respond to these fires are critical.
Yeah, and when it comes to climate change, it's not like we haven't been warned. We'll leave it there for the moment. Noah Diffenbaugh, a professor of earth sciences at Stanford University. Thank you, Professor.
Thank you.